Stephanie Link, Chief Investment Strategist, Portfolio Manager at Hightower Advisors. She's also a CNBC contributor. The Christmas tree's up already. Thank you.
Were Christmas tree's
Stephanie's house?
Yep.
No
Christmas
way.
Tree's already up.
It's going to live in 2 weeks.
I was thinking of doing it for Thanksgiving.
Different than last
year,
too.
You beat me to the punch. I like the red. That's pretty.
Different than last year.
Like the White House. They got it in a different one every year, too.
The scariest thing was I literally thought it was like 2 weeks ago when I was talking about how she had taken it down. Time is going so quick.
I take it down the first week of January, Joe. You know that. Like I put it up early, but I take it down early.
The blink of an eye. The blink of an eye.
I know.
It's just already happened. Stephanie, if consumers... without question, we just heard feeling the pinch, pulling back. Journal talks about what a wonderful soft landing we've orchestrated, but consumers are starting to pull back. Should you be in any retail? Is it maybe just step aside, or if so, which ones do you buy?
Well, I mean, I think it is a mixed picture for sure, but I don't count out the consumer, Joe, because the job market we've been talking about forever is still very strong. Wages are still up. Inflation is down. Gasoline prices are down about 40 cents year over year, and that actually frees up potential spend of about $54 billion. So I think that there are pockets of strength in the consumer and pockets of weakness, clearly. I think in the services side, we've talked about it kind of ad nauseum. That continues to be where people are spending. I look at something like McDonald's up 9% in sales. I look at Expedia up 9%. I look at Starbucks up 8%, all in North America. And then I look on the good side, and there are some areas there as well. Look at Lululemon up 11% and Amazon up 11%. So I think there are pockets. I think you have to be very careful. With Walmart, I think you want to be especially careful because the expectations were so high. The stock's up 20% year to date, trades at 26 times forward estimates, and everybody was hiding out in it because 60% of their business is consumables. It's almost like a consumer staples company. So I obviously want to pay attention to what they say about the consumer, but I don't think we're in a dire situation. And I do think that there are areas. I own Target and I own TJX, and I think those are both buys.
You own Target. That's an interesting one. It was, do you remember when it was 250? So that move yesterday was a welcome move for shareholders.
Yeah.
You can't see it there. We go back a little bit further. The all-time high was over 200. I know that. So it has been 250. It seems like there's a lot of room to get back to where it was, but is that in the cards? Is that going to happen?
I think so. It's down 50% from November 21 highs. They clearly were a beneficiary of COVID, and that's kind of wearing we're kind of seeing that play itself through. I think the expectations are extremely low. You can make a case after yesterday's quarter that next year they have earnings power of something like $9 to $10 a share. That makes it very cheap at 13 times forward estimates. And the story is not necessarily the sales. We want to see sales come through, but not yet. It's early. But we want to see the margin story pick up. And profitability was the thing yesterday that was so positive because operating margins came in much better than expected. Operating margins 5.2% versus a 4% expected. Their goal is to get that back to 6% over the next couple of years. And I think they can do it. And they've done a really good job in terms of inventory control. Their inventories were down 14% and in discretionary down 19%. And so it's important to kind of look at Walmart is more consumables and Target, unfortunately, is more discretionary. So they've been trying to change that mix. It just doesn't happen overnight. But I think they'll get there.
Whenever you're talking about all these things and I'm seeing the plastic cases again, I mean, do you think that shrink can actually hurt margins? Can it? I mean, that's real money.
Yeah.
It comes at some point. Could they actually benefit from locking up their stuff so it doesn't get stolen and they actually get to sell it? Could that actually appear on the bottom line?
Yeah. I mean, shrink still hurt them about 40 basis points to margins, and yet their margins, gross margins, actually rose 273 basis points. So they're doing other things. Sure, everyone's having shrink problems. They did actually, by the way, say shrink was less bad. I don't know if that makes me feel good, but less bad is better than worse, right? But again, they had lower markdowns. They had lower freight costs. They had lower digital costs. Their mix is changing again, a little bit less discretion, a little bit more consumables, and all that is helping the margin picture. And I think that they're going to continue to do all these things in the coming years. And again, I mean, the stock is down so much. Yeah. By the way, the sell side, there are 20 buys on the stock, but there are 21 holds and sells on it too. So it's not really well loved versus Walmart, where you have 70% of the sell side has buys on that stock.
Yeah.